this pedal is extraordinarily hard to turn off once you've been using it for, say, 20 minutes, half an hour, and you turn it off and you think, what the hell happened to my amplifier? You just want to turn it straight back on again. This is the Enhancifier, depending how you pronounce it, Psychoacoustic Analog Psychoacoustic Boost from Disruptive Music Technology of Longmont in Colorado, which is about 20 or 30 k's northeast of Boulder, if I'm not mistaken. And it comes to me from my friend Wayne, who sent it over with Sean Tubbs' recommendation, I might add, which is very nice of you, Sean. Thanks, mate. If you haven't seen Sean Tubbs' YouTube channel, it's amazing. He is an extraordinarily accomplished player, lovely bloke, and does great guitar demos. So I'm flattered to have Sean's recommendation. But back to the Enhancifier. We've got a level control up the top here, and it'll take you from sort of zero up to, I don't know how many dB boost it is, but it's quite a lot. They recommend you start at about 2 with any given amplifier. Underneath it, we've got the tight low frequency and the high frequency rich analog kind of mid boost tightening up psychoacoustic mid-range controls. Below it, we have the sizzle and the full control, which takes you basically from a full range boost to a sizzle boost type boost, which is reminiscent of a classic treble booster. At 5 here on the marker, it's not going to do anything. This is a Les Paul Classic. It has some Sovereign 59 PAF style pickups, A5, and I'm running in, built by my friend Ben Bailey at JJ's Guitar Pickups. G'day, Ben. This is a Marshall SV20H. I'm into the treble channel in the low inputs to give this some room to move. And the sound with our bridge pickup sounds like that. Turn this guy on. We've got a level control, obviously. We can turn it up to, say, 6, and it's going to push the front end of the amp. This is on 5 at the moment, so it's not doing anything. We'll get to him in a second. First of all, let's just pop this guy at midnight or midday and use this tight control to hear what it does. It's going to tighten up the bass. Let's go to the neck pickup for a minute. So it's adding that sort of beautiful polish and sheen around the note. It's leaving space as well, which is what psychoacoustics do. A bit reminiscent of an 1176 or an LA2 in terms of what it, how it glues things together and just gives it that sound that you when you turn it on, you think, oh, yes, that's what I was looking for. That's what the Enhancifier does. So if I go clockwise here, we're going to get more bass with still the tightened bass. So tight. It's just widening it a little bit. You can almost see it dimensionally. Back to this neck pickup. If I turn it down, clean it up a bit. It's just enhancing the bottom end. Excuse this microphone cable's driving me crazy. All right, I'm going to put this back to noon and we're going to have a look at this high frequency and rich control. Back to the bridge pickup. The Enhancifier is off. So with that high frequency control all the way anti-clockwise, it again is giving me that poke, sort of the upper mids poke. If I go over to the rich side, it's shifted that mid-range focus into a rich zone. Again, the semi-clean neck pickup. So it's doing something good. Anti-clockwise. Giving it that treble booster poke. clearly they're interactive with each other to create a much broader range of tones. And then you can boost it even more with the level control here, which, as I said, has got a lot of level. And then below it, we have the sizzle and the full control. So if I've, let's just turn him off for a moment and give it a bit of level here. All right, if I turn it clockwise, I'm going to get full frequency boost. And if I go anti-clockwise into sizzle territory, I'm going to get almost like a treble boost. And then I can continue to shape that with these guys. Let's go for the semi-clean neck pickup again. Full frequency. So if I wanted to sort of get the Marshall really cooking, for instance, I might give the high frequency a bit of a nudge here, and I might inject a little tiny bit of the tighter bass, but the low frequency, not too much, about 2 o'clock. Run this guy around 5 or 6, and run the full frequency as well, and then I'd get this from, this is without the enhancifier. So it's going to have a lot of applications for many different guitars and many different types of amplifiers. It just depends how you use it. But in terms of what it does, it's definitely related in my mind to the 1176 and LA2 and any other, you know, sort of upper-end studio, high-end studio device that, you know, when you switch it on, you just think, oh yeah, that's the missing piece. That's what it does. And it's good fun to use while you're playing and mixing, because you can make it tune in on certain frequencies and give you that psycho acoustic enhancement. That's what it does. I'm going to go back to the jam track. See you later. Disruptive Music Tech Enhancifier. Check it out. See you soon.